I love music. So good. It is so good. This video, I put like regular music, and I've been on this whole Jai Wolf. I think that's how you say his name. I'll link it down below. And I've just been on a kick of his music, and it's so good. So all the music in this vlog will be from him, and hopefully when I upload this, it'll work with the channel. But as promised, we're doing Inhand stuff today. Let's roll. I'm assuming most of you guys watch these vlogs on your phones. Let me know where you actually watch these vlogs. But I bet most of you watch them on the phone. And what sucks about that is then the audio sucks. So if you can, grab a set of headphones, especially for this one, because I tried to put some good music in this vlog, and the whole experience is so much better with a pair of headphones. Or a good sound system, that works too. Let's do this. Man, it is ridiculously hot today. In some ways, that's a good time to work your horses in hand, because you can work slowly and work progressively, and you don't really have to work them all that hard. I think a lot of times with in-hand work, people think Piaf training and not just general horse training. And that, I think, is a massive, massive thing to remember. Build something small and correct and progressive. And I'm gonna show you that today. Like, just build these little building blocks. It doesn't have to be that when you work a horse in hand, you're working on the Piaf. It's actually better if you're working on small little pieces that then down the road, in a year or in a long time, you can develop into the Piaf, into a more correct Piaf. It's just, I mean, it's no different than training horses. Somehow people get in hand and they think of it differently. Got Finn out. Show you how he is. Now that I told you guys about watching this with headphones and the importance of audio and the music and everything, now I have to like make sure that you guys can hear me as I'm talking out there. So I'm gonna switch over to this other microphone, and I've had like hit and miss results with it, so hopefully it's good today. All right, so I'm excited about this when there's like a new idea that I know makes a big impact. And like, I've known this before, but it's like sometimes in the horsemanship process, it just takes a while until you're like, holy crap. Like, have you ever had that experience where like a trainer is telling you something over and over and over again, and then one day you're just like, I get it. Like, I totally get it. You have to kind of go through that process on your own until you finally learn it. And so it's kind of been that way with me with this stuff. Like, I've done so much in-hand work in a round pen, against a wall, in an arena, against a wall. And for me, I think this step is actually really, really important. And I'm starting to feel that. I'm starting to understand that and learn that this is actually a big piece for my in-hand work. So what you're gonna do, let me move him over here. So if you have an arena like this, it's a dressage arena, but really you have no border, no wall to work against. So if you have an arena like this, you need to be able to work the horse in hand without them just swinging the haunches away. So we do so much groundwork like this, as I've shown in videos before, where we're teaching the horse to yield the hind leg under and away. And that's really good work, really important work, bending, yielding. But can we teach the horse also to stay with us if we move away from them? So we move towards them, the haunches moves away. We move away, the haunches comes towards us. And you have to teach this very slowly. You have to kind of build this over time. So let me show you here. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my in-hand whip and I'm gonna reach over and touch the right hip, his right hip. And they may not know at first, they may try to move away, but I'm just gonna start really gradually touching here until he steps toward me. See, he's not quite sure. I've never done this with this horse before. Just there, until he steps the right hind leg under toward me. So I'm gonna start a little bit. Maybe he switches his tail. He says, I don't really know what you're asking. Just hang in there. Yeah, hang in there. And he's processing this. He's new to this, so I'll give him a little bit of time. There, until the haunches step like that there. Good boy, that's all I need. So hopefully that was in frame. But it's like, it's just like that. You start really small, reach across on top of the croup, and touch until the croup, until the haunches moves towards you, and then quit. And then you can find a balance point between reaching over and reaching on this side, and reaching over and reaching on this side. And over time, teach the horse that the haunches can move away from you and the haunches can move towards you. Let me try once more. You can hold the halter here with your hand. Then reach over, touch the haunches, not too forward. He thinks forward there, so I'm gonna block the forward. I don't want a forward reaction. There, like this. That's the reaction I want. Good boy. Good boy. There's a story that people tell about Ray Hunt. And what they say is that Ray was at a clinic once and he started picking up the reins, and as soon as the horse would go against the rein, he would reward the horse. And his wife asked him, she said, but Ray, doesn't that go against everything that you've ever taught your horse? And Ray said no. Like, her question was, don't you always teach your horse pick up the rein and they give to the rein? But Ray said, what you teach your horse is to follow a feel. And that if there's an area of pressure and an area of relief, you want them to search. When you apply pressure, you want them to search. And if one day you come out and you change the expectation, like here, changing the expectation from I step in, you move the haunches away. All of a sudden I've changed it. Now I have to be tactful here when I change it. But what's most important is that the horse follows a feel in that presentation, not just this robotic push button type, give an aid and they respond to a cue in a robotic way. You really want them feeling, where's the pressure, where's the relief, every single day that you're training them. And then if one day you come out and you want to change things, you can. And to me, that's one of the best things about horsemanship. If one day you present it differently, these guys will do it. They'll do it correct. They're very forgiving that way. So if you present it in the right way, they'll do it. All right. I think that's it. Let's roll. Drifting through a memory. I'm taking time lapses of traffic when the ocean is like right there, like right over that hill. Let's go get some shots of the ocean. Better, it's not even funny. So beautiful. I freaking love California. There are a lot of people here, but I think I can deal with it. So I'm like, I get more proud of the good stuff, you know? I think, I was thinking about it when I was shooting my time lapses. I think the like broad point that I want to make in this episode is like, we don't want to make push button horses. Like, even though we want to teach them to respond to different aids, we still want horses that are feeling and searching. And if one day we want to come change that aid or change that feel that we're presenting, that they're still searching for that. I don't want like robotic horses. I want really feely horses. So yeah, I guess that's it. If you guys want to keep watching these videos, make sure you're subscribed. And if you click, there's a little bell, then you'll get like an email when I post a video. I think you will at least. All right, guys, we'll see you in the next one.